All right, Michelle Glass here, and our job for today is to go through the bones of the face. So we have other videos that go through all of the cranial bones individually. With the facial bones, we don't have as many features to learn for each of these, so I'll just do one video on these. So the other thing to pay attention to with the facial bones is that you have a left and a right, so make sure you're looking at that as well. So to start with, let's do the zygomatic bone, which is this bone here. The zygomatic bone is the bone that people commonly refer to as the cheekbone. For the zygomatic bone, the only thing that we need to label besides the bone itself is what's called the temporal process. So the temporal process is this part of the zygomatic bone that's reaching out and touching the zygomatic process of the temporal bone. So make sure you're paying attention that the process is named based on the bone it's touching, not for the bone that it's a part of. While we're looking here, we can also look inside that eye orbit a little bit. Let's see, right here, you can see this bone, medial side here of the eye orbit. That is called the lacrimal bone. And if I angle it just so and get my pointer, should be able to stick my pointer into the nasolacrimal canal. Nasolacrimal canal is part of the lacrimal bone. You can see that on both sides. You also have what's called the nasal bone here. You have the vomer. Is this bone here that is making the bony septum between the left and right sides of the nasal cavity. It's meeting up and touching with the perpendicular plate of the ethmoid bone. We have these bottom ridges in the nasal cavity called the inferior nasal conchae with an AE ending or conch. So left and right of those. And then we have the bone of the upper jaw, which is the maxillary bone. You have actually a left and right maxilla, so that is separate bone here. Now with this bone, we are going to name the foramen, which are located underneath the eye orbit. So these are called the infraorbital foramen. You have these alveolar parts to the maxilla. They're making these little sockets that hold the teeth. The term alveoli just means like a pocket. So we'll see it used several places in the body. And when you're looking at the roof of the mouth here, you have what's called the palatine process, which is part of the maxillary bone. At the back of the roof of the mouth here, you have two bones called palatine bone. So it's making part of the roof of the mouth, and then we'll see it coming up here as well. So it's in front of the pterygoid process of the sphenoid bone, and you'll see that the palatine bone is gonna form some of that eye socket as well. So far we have our zygomatic bone with our temporal process. We have our lacrimal bone with the nasolacrimal canal. Get my pointer there. We have the nasal bone. We have the vomer. So we have just one vomer. We have left and right nasal conchae. So these are these bottom ridges. We have the left and right maxillary bones. We have the infraorbital foramen, alveolar part of the maxilla. So that's these little extensions of the bone forming these sockets for the teeth. We have the palatine process of the maxillary bones here. And then we have left and right palatine bone forming the very back part of the roof of the mouth and extending up here as well. The last bone of the face for us to name is the mandible, so the lower jaw. For the mandible, you have this whole part of the mandible is referred to as the body, and then this point here is the angle. And then this part of the bone that's sticking up to articulate with the rest of the skull is called the ramus. So we have the body of the mandible, the angle, and the ramus. Body of the mandible, angle, and ramus. You have foramen on the front of the mandible here on the chin, called the mental foramen. The term mental means chin. You can see where this model has lost its teeth. You can see the alveolar portion of the mandible. You can see how the bone is extending up to form those little pockets. You have two processes on the ramus. So you have the coronoid process, which is closer to the crown of your molars. And then you have the condylar process, which is going to make the condyle. Remember, the term condyle means smooth, rounded, articular surface. So the condylar process is going to be making that articulation with the skull. It's the condylar process that's fitting into the mandibular fossa that was part of the temporal bone. In between the coronoid and condylar process, you have the mandibular notch. And then when you're looking at the inside view of the mandible, on the ramus, you have what's called the mandibular foramen. So you have body of the mandible, angle, and ramus. You have the mental foramen on the front, alveolar portion. On the ramus, you have the coronoid process, mandibular notch, condylar process, and then here you have the mandibular foramen. And that's it for the facial bones.